Hello, and welcome to another session of Webby Class English Higher. This is the third of the three-part series that I've been dealing with the use of the comma. And today, we are looking at the participial phrase. In other words, still another way of using the comma as objective for today. We have this. By the end of today's lesson, you should be able to say why we need a comma why we need a comma when we use a participial phrase. Look at this. Having chosen a place to hide, Mustafa began to run. Having chosen a place to run to hide, Mustafa began to run. Having chosen a place to hide is the participial phrase. You may read a bit more about participles and participial phrases. Now, so after having chosen a place to hide, there should be a comma, because even as I'm saying it, you will hear that having chosen a place to hide, at that point we need a comma, we need a pause. That is why after a participial phrase, there should be a comma. Now, a participial phrase doesn't have to be at the beginning of the sentence. It can come at the end of the sentence, as you can see in this example. Mustafa began to run, comma, having chosen a place to hide. So the participial phrase, having chosen a place to hide, is not brought to the end of the sentence. And still, because of the introduction of that participial phrase, there must be a comma separating the two parts of the sentence. So whether the participial phrase is placed at the beginning of the sentence or at the end, there must be a comma before or after the participial phrase accordingly. Great. One thing to remember, that the three lessons we've had so far on the use of the comma have a basic point. The basic point is that a comma is used when there's a pause. So, when you believe that you need a pause, just use the comma. The danger is that some people use the comma when they don't have to. For example, I came to see you, comma, because no. Normally, no one expects you to pause after because. So, we can only hope that your judgment is right when you think there should be a comma used somewhere. I wish you all the best in your use of the comma. These are supplementary ideas which you will use in addition to what you know already about using the comma. Thank you. And hold on for your takeaway.
Today's takeaway. Write three sentences using the comma in three different ways.
Right. Thank you for another session. And I look forward to seeing you in the next lesson. Bye-bye.